I'll tell you a phrase I use quite often, which I said to patients, I'd like to tell you what's in my mind about your illness. Now, that was true, but it wasn't completely true. So if I had a... I pretty well thought I knew what was going on. But, you know, you have these sort of ticking off orders of probability in your mind. And somewhere at the bottom in was some horrible cancer, which I'm pretty sure they didn't have. I didn't mention it, of course. So it was true, but it wasn't the whole truth. And I did lie. When I saw more dying patients, I lied to them too, when I sensed that they didn't want to have that kind of conversation.
Lie in the... Do you want...
Well, I remember the very first time, actually. It's funny, these individual things. I was the house surgeon on the surgical unit. A man was dying of cancer of the pancreas with secondaries. And I went on the night round, which, you know, in those days when people did night rounds, now they're so busy, poor devils, they couldn't possibly be rushing from one person to another. It was the really big time for knowing what was going on. And he could just lift his head off the pillow. He said, I will be all right, won't I, doctor? And I took a deep breath and I said, you'll be fine. What does the ethicist say about that?
What does the practical doctor in you say about it? Would you change that now?
No, I wouldn't. No. And the hospice movement, although it's tremendously valuable, I mean, hugely changing, you do detect sometimes there's a bit of an agenda. This is the moment when we have everything out.
Yes.
Oh, some people want it and some people don't.